Shout out to thank you. Yeah, okay, we literally had like nothing going on. I'm excited to be so appreciated. you guys for that so far. Nico is the latest in the chatter. And just to clarify, because recently someone's been asking questions such as, well, Bill, when you track tips and all that, that's great, but why don't you track all super chats? Okay, here's a perfect example why. This morning, $2 tips have been passed of €5.99 super chat from Mickey Phil and a €2 super chat from Nico. I don't know currency here, right? And that's the thing, YouTube allows you to do these super chats in any currency. I'm not going to sit here every time that I get a super chat and start with the currency conversions to figure out who's the biggest contributor. Okay? That's the big, major problem in YouTube. You have all the same currency. I need fun. Oh, God. Chapters. Sadly, you know what I do is I just put up the last super chat. So that way,
said they were going to head over to the training hall. Should we head over there too?
Sad fact is there's just more morons on this planet. these whatever because they're stupid. If they want to drop one, they don't want to hear about your hook. So I don't care about them. You know? It's that simple. Okay, let's continue. Well, I received a dollar tip. Right now, I don't have a countdown like Mario games. Favorite Mario games is Mario games. At work, but is there any better idea that you guys have for information? I would like to join your major journey.
Thank you.
trauma for reacting to longer bleeders instead of watching all of it while I'm not skipping the good parts because I don't know what the good parts are. You have to remember my old bleeders are literally just numbers. It doesn't even have a name in the title, so you don't even know what's in the part. You have no clue. And I said, I wish that I could better tell you back in the day, but until I started making field titles, you don't have a name. What happened?
Content for non-team audience. And that was reflected in the fact that I didn't do any content.
contributions on the stream whatsoever. I didn't shout out anyone on the stream whatsoever. Like I said, I literally hate for the audience. If you go back and watch my videos from 2013, 12 years, 2017, I'm not talking to anyone. Really, there's nothing like that at all. It's just me playing a game.
Okay.
More than half. Generating enough revenue to actually keep going. So imagine me uploading a video here going, hey, you're going to go go out of business within a year. Number two, Kate does not have proper moderation going forward. It's just not controllable enough from an environment. The amount of trolling I get, the entirety of the chat would be horrible stuff, racist stuff, doxing, all kinds of stuff. If you can't control that, there's no point in this. So, yeah.
Progress is getting right. Okay, guys.
Alright guys, let's get set up. I do need to, I'm gonna go and break through the restroom. I'll be back. And, just see you in a little bit, okay, guys? Thanks. I'll be right back. Thank you.
Let's go.
So meaningful that these clips don't show. You meaningful Chrysopras today. Hashtag Chrysopras.
Nice. Watch. Thank you.
I'm gonna go check on the ship. Let's meet up later on, okay? See ya.
Impressionante porque esse cyborg considerava ele uma das maiores figuras dessa escala.
In Customs and for this review, we are looking at the S.H. Vineyards Monkey D. Luffy the Raid on Onigashima version, which I'm hoping they make other versions. So we're going to do a question of the day right away. Which version of Luffy is your favorite? I'm just attached to the three-time skip, so I like the blue jeans and not the scar, but the scar is cool. So, you know, it's kind of like, I like them both, but I prefer, I would like to have the blue three-time skip version. Let me know which one you guys want, though. I'm sure they're going to make more. I'm guessing they are anyway. And then I want to do another question of the day right away, because it looks like we're going to be getting all of the Shonen characters released from SH Figure Arts, which is an awesome thing. Which of the big three is your favorite? You have Dragon Ball, any version, doesn't matter which one, One Piece, and Naruto. I guess you could include Bleach. Okay, we'll do Bleach. I'll throw Bleach out there, though. I think, I'm just guessing, I haven't checked the numbers. I think Bleach is number four, though, as far as popularity goes. Which is your favorite? For me, I'm going to have to go One Piece, Dragon Ball, then Bleach, then Naruto, then everything else, and then Naruto. But okay, let's go ahead and talk about this figure. It's pretty darn cool. There's one really strange thing about it, a couple things that aren't great, but overall, it's a really, really solid release. So make sure you stick around and hear all the nitty-gritty. So let's go ahead and get this guy off the stand and take a closer look. Real quick before we get into the review, we will look at my package just because it's a new one. I like the way they've done it. It does have a hint of the way they've been doing the Dragon Ball with the separate panels and things, but it has this nice background that looks like a map for the packaging that shows the figure. I think it's a really nice looking package. It suits One Piece, but it does fit in nicely with Dragon Ball stuff too, and even the Naruto stuff, I suppose, for the most part. Okay, for those of you who collected package, I have satisfied my responsibilities. Okay, this guy stands roughly, of course you can post a little bit different, but we'll just call it 15 centimeters. There's a little bit of head sticking up above that, but we'll call it 15 centimeters. That's going to be just about 6 inches, roughly. Here he is up against good old Marvel Legends Darwin. I think that's close enough. If you wanted to scale these together, put these together on a display, you could. Marvel Legends and SH Figure Arts are close enough, I think, that you could get by, but most of the bigger SH Figure Arts figures tend to scale down, so you might have some issues with it. There you go. And I'm sure you guys are wondering how he's going to scale, so here he is up against the kind of go-to standard Goku. He's actually got a little bit of height on him if you look at the top of his head, but they're definitely close enough to scale it. And it definitely won't be a problem. Of course, there are different art styles completely, but if you wanted to mix the Shonen characters, it's more than doable, so that's perfectly good. Real quick, guys, before we get into the review, we have to talk about the sponsor of today's video, which is Into the AM. Their website sees all the different things they have, which is kind of strange. I don't see any of that darker brownish color in any noticeable way anywhere else. Oh, it's down the seam of his butt, too. That's unfortunate shading. It doesn't look as bad in person as it does on camera. But that is unfortunate shading for his pants. It's not super duper obvious, so I'm not terribly worried about it, but it's not great. The paintwork for the ruffle is clean enough. It's not really a ruffle, I know. And that's good. And then the paintwork on his chest is really nice. The buttons and the scar both look awesome. That's a good thing. The face, perfectly acceptable. I like it. They do tend to soften up the features a little bit more than I think I would do. They do that for Dragon Ball and Dragon Ball, so it's not as nicely detailed as it could be, perhaps, but given the art style of One Piece, I think you're probably okay with that. Then we have a little bit of paintwork for the hat, which is thin enough. I guess lastly is the foot paint. Actually a character that makes sense wearing sandals to Rudy fans. They did a really clean job painting those straps. So paint-wise, it's pretty good. It's going to have a little bit more, but it's not bad. Now as far as the rest of it, I think the finish is nice. The only thing that stands out to me is the pants are a little bit shiny. But everything else is a nice matte or satin finish, and it looks really good. I guess his torso is a little shiny too, a little bit, but you could always argue sweat. So it's not bad. It looks pretty darn good. I think the sculpt is really nice. Very pleased with that. I think they captured the character pretty nicely. I'd have to check. His lower legs are ridiculously long. I know One Piece has very stylized artwork, so it might be right. I haven't watched One Piece in forever. It might be right that his lower legs are ridiculously long, but otherwise, it looks pretty darn good. So for $35, this thing gets a 9 out of 10. That's a whole lot of figure for $35. I'm very, very pleased with that. Now, as far as the accessories go, this guy's kind of a Gohan situation where other figures are coming with accessories for him. I think they've only shown faceplates, though, so far. So maybe eventually we'll get some, like, effect parts for his hands or something. But in this package, you get the neutral face that comes out of the package. You get one where his teeth are showing, one where his mouth is open, his teeth are showing, and then one where it's all cartooned out. So that's pretty good. You get the head that holds the hat, and then you get alternate headpiece that is just hair. So that's pretty good. You have your options there. And for hands, it comes with the two fist hands, and you get two karate chop kind of hands, and then two style post hands. That's it. Not a lot in the package. Again, I think for $35, that's fair enough. I would have been happy to pay for it and get like a big fist or something. Something that indicates he has some kind of ability from his double shrimp power. So that's kind of unfortunate. Decent enough spread for the price. I'll go 8 out of 10 for accessories. Bases, hands, hair, that's fine. But yeah, could be more. And I think we'll get more down the road in some way or another. Alrighty, now for articulation, I have some good news and some bad news. The bad news is some of the joints are a little bit loose and one tongue has been going, but you probably see it as we're going. But otherwise, there's some good stuff here. So, double ball peg, which, as I always tell you, is the best thing. And it is, you can just move the head around, especially with a ball peg in the neck. You can just move the head around however you want, whenever you want, without any finickiness, without any hassle. It's just exactly what you need in a joint. Now, this joint is not the hat coming off. I did let my daughter play with this. I was watching her, so I knew she wouldn't need any of the edible parts. Non-edible parts, choking hazard parts. Okay, so she probably pulled out the stuff. But yeah, that right there. Head does pop up a little bit too easily, and that's kind of the problem, because the other head doesn't come with the ball peg. So I think that's the result of the interchangeability, because the whole ball peg system comes out of this head, goes into the other head, so they needed it to swap easily. It's not like it's super loose, but I think it could be a little bit tighter. Like, the head doesn't stay on super well the way they've done it. It's not especially connected, but it should be fine. Alright, so the head does pose really well. The shoulders, they did something I really don't like, and that is to not have this shoulder be the actual joint. It's more like a Revoltech figure where the shoulder is a cap over a joint. And in this case, it works okay, but it's so unnecessary. I don't know why they did that. It's very strange. There's no butterfly joint in there, as far as I can tell. If there is one, mine does not. I thought there was, but I couldn't get either side. We have this double ball hinge system, which is just overkill and so unnecessary. I think they did that to avoid a butterfly joint. We're going to see right now how that works. This is a soft piece, by the way, but it is connected to the body. So these little cuts do help, but they don't help a ton. So let's see. We can raise the arm that far. So that's good. It's better than horizontal. That's really
It'll
nice.
It'll be pretty calm from here
rotation.
On.
Rotation. The rotation
a good breeze,
is
too. So we should be fine.
The rotation happens all the way in there, which is reasonable enough, but it's fairly far set into the torso. So you immediately start pushing against that soft plastic.
He said that
and
his cargo was
okay.
Spicy.
Also,
he?
My rotation is very stiff on this figure. But you do get it, so just be careful with that. It's a little bit strange. It feels like you're
stressing
the joint a
whole lot. I managed to catch a glimpse of Mr. Romano's cargo before we departed
pinch,
from the port.
As the shoulder is down, you
there
can
were containers
up,
of room cannon ammunition.
Which,
really
no
big ones at that.
I don't get why they did that. That's not
I've never seen anything like them. They had to be at least 5 to 10 times
shifted.
Larger than the ones we use. Can you imagine? If you got hit by something like that,
but
even a single shot could sink a galleon.
But you can see how the joint is not a fun joint to use. It's too high up, it's too far back, this one back here. And so
do
this double joint system, plus you can see how tiny that one inside is. That little tiny joint inside this big shoulder has virtually no usability. And that's the problem we see with all of these, most of the shoulders that work like this. So you get a little bit of a butterfly out of that. But is it worth it? I guess if you're going for a very specific photo, sure. But to me, I think even a less than ideal butterfly joint with a better shoulder probably would have been more effective. And it certainly would have been more pleasant to handle. This is kind of a pain in the butt. You do get your bicep swivel right here. I don't like that they did this right here. You can see the cut. They didn't try to even hide it. You get to see the flat here on that direction and the flat there. It's not a big deal. It's a relatively small piece of plastic, so it doesn't really stand out too much. But I think they could have used the wrinkles to just round that part out just a little bit and not have the ugly cut for the bicep swivel, you know? Double jointed elbow works very nicely, really good range, the attractive joint, no problem there. They did go kind of hard on the sculpt for the forearm. You see it's very detailed, there's a lot of curve to it. So using the wrist joint, which works really well, it does look weird in some poses, so you're going to have to kind of play around with that. that to make it look right. When you turn the hand like this, since the forearm doesn't rotate, it does look kind of disjointed, but it's not a huge deal. All right, for the upper torso, we have a ball peg. You don't get a ton of range out of it because of the jacket, but he does lean back about that far. Leaning forward is much better. So that's good. And it's forward nicely. Side to side, not a ton on that top joint, but it is there. So that's good. You do get some rotation out of it, but it's pretty oblong. So you're not going to get a whole lot. Then they did this weird thing where they put in the upside down ab crunch, which is fine because there's a joint down here, so it's not an issue like that. It just doesn't seem to do much. That's as far back as I can get it to go. And as you can tell, it's pretty much still just flat abs. Like, he's leaning down here. So if I straighten that out, he's not leaning very far back at all on that ab crunch. So that's a little bit weird. Now, if I try to force him forward on that ab crunch, that's as far as he goes forward only. So it's pretty limited. You're still going to use this joint down here to bring him forward. And this joint up here. Together, they work well enough. I'm just not sure that this ab crunch actually adds enough to bother being in there to break up the sculpt and to raise the cost. It's a little bit weird. Now, down here, we do have the floating belt, which is actually connected to the crotch of the pants. That's a little bit new for most of the figures they release. This is on a little ball peg, so it gets out of the way. But this joint, this ball peg down here, is where you get almost all of your torso range. He leans back very far. He leans forward pretty far. And when you use all the joints together, you get the rest of that. So it does work out nicely. And then going side to side, you get so much range out of this lower ball peg. It just goes to show what I've been saying all these years. That if you're going to have the ab crunch, you need to have rotation down there also. And all that extra range is so much of a benefit. Hasbro or any of the other companies that refuse to put a ball peg or even a swivel down here in addition to the ab crunch, just pay attention. Uh-huh. Look, it works so well. It works nicely. Okay, so for the hips,
that's
out of rotation. Good parts on the starboard side. Primarily on the pants, so it gets a little gappy in the pose, but you do get the range going back, which is very nice. As opposed to having that cheek right there sculpted onto the crotch piece, you would be able to bring the leg back. So I do like that you can get basically a full-on forward split, which is nice, especially for a character like Luffy where he needs to be pretty agile. I like that. Going out to the side, standard hinge, basically. And you get basically full-on splits, which is perfectly good to me. I will take that. There is a little bit of shading here. I'm seeing it now. I think it's just super shuttle. Something happened to hit right here. A little bit more shading, but yeah, there's definitely shading in the pants. So I appreciate that. I take back what I said earlier. It looks pretty good. I don't know.
Captain, we're under fire! Your
order,
sir!
This is hit a little bit too heavy. But yeah, okay. So, the legs were nicely tight. I think over here at the hip, you get that down here.
Captain?
Where the flesh plastic connects to. It's actually a ball peg. You can move the leg around the inside. So that's nice. It can be nice. Well, that works wonderfully. Now, here's the super weird thing about this figure. It's so strange, and a lot of the front.
Return to Polaris! Go to full speed! Quickly! But, Captain, if we do that, the Auror trade ship will sink for certain! Please, just steer us to port! I can't take this anymore! Are you saying we're going to flee and abandon our mission?
Yeah, so if you look right here, there were other photos that I noticed before. That leg is clearly cutting through the shorts. The calf is cutting through the shorts. Or it's really generous photography.
Yes, sir! Hard to starboard! We'll close it on the enemy ship at full speed! What are you saying? I'm the captain here! You must follow my orders!
He only goes that far. What if you look at this? This is a separate piece of plastic back here, and there's a pit hole right here.
What do you think you're doing?
At some point, it looks to me like they planned for this to be a hinge.
The ship is going to sink.
Doesn't look like it can either. But this should have been. Plus, even if it could, like, this is in the off position. So I'm thinking what they did is they scrapped the idea at some point and said, well, that's good enough. But this looks like it should go down and up farther, but it doesn't. It's just stuck in that position on both sides. So I don't know what happened, but it really does affect the joint. The knee sucks. It's less than 90 degrees. Somebody crouches down and gets into all these crazy poses like a frog and stuff. It's just whatever happened here, though. That's really, really unfortunate. Unless they're going to release a better version that costs more someday. And it's really strange how they left it on. obviously, if you guys have anything about One Piece, you know there's a ton of characters.
Thank you.
Surrender now. The Orok trade ship has departed, and your ship has been consigned to the depths of the ocean. So you're the pirate Brando. You've really got guts picking a fight with the knights. But you'll regret that decision in the afterlife.
Master Brando! No! Not that!
All of you...
Don't!
Die!
Fools, run! Run away! Quickly! We'll be turned to ash!
Is that snow?
No.
Commander! It's terrible! The ship! The ship!
Incredible. So you decided to just abandon your ship?
I know, but my arm! My arm wouldn't move, don't you understand?
You coward! What kind of captain leaves his men in order to save himself? The captain is always last to leave!
But my arm! My arm wouldn't move! Look!
This is pointless. Don't die. What?
He's alive. Will you be next?
Thank you.
I'll kill you.
Yeah. Commander, are you all right?